Hello everyone, welcome to my channel AnyLearn Nepal. This is the video series of Fortran tutorial and today we will summarize our previous lessons using some numerical problems. Okay, here is a question to solve. Find the midpoint of 2,4 and 4,-10, and the formula for the midpoint is x, y equals to x1 plus x2 by 2 and y1 plus y2 by 2. So we are going to solve this using a Fortran. During problem solving we will be using our concepts from the previous lessons. So if you have not watched my previous videos, watch it first and then come back. First thing we will do is create a variable to store the value of these two coordinates, and we will again create a variable to store our answer. Okay, so I'll write the steps first. First thing we have to do is declare the variable and then give value to variables, then use formula and finally display the result. So these are the steps we will follow to solve this problem. Okay, first thing first, give the program and give any name. I'll give example and don't forget to end program. You can also write end program and the program name, but is not necessary to write. Now implicit none. Okay, so we are going to declare the variable. I will declare them as a real because most of the time we use the data type real while solving the problems. X1 variable to store the first x coordinate and y1, okay, and x2 and y2. X1 and y1 to store 2,4 and x2 and y2 to store 4,-10. Then we will declare x and y to store our midpoint answer. So declaration completed. Now let's give them value. X1 equals to 2, okay, and y1 equals to 4, and x2 equals to 4, y2 equals to -10. So now let's use the formula here. Okay, now we can't write formula in this form. This is the formula from the coordinate geometry. Fortran does not understand the coordinate system. So we have to give individual formula. So first x coordinate formula, that is x1 plus x2 divided by 2. Okay, 2, but better to give 2.0. y equals to y1 plus y2 divided by 2.0. okay, so formula also completed. Okay, now let's display the result. So x and y are two answers, but let's use some text also. I'll write the midpoint is, okay, and don't forget to use comma as a separator. Okay, now let's run this. So variable.f95, okay, and okay, so we got our answer 3n-3. So basically this is the idea to solve any numerical problem in Fortran. Okay, let's move on to the next question. Find gravitational force exerted by earth on a 1 kg mass lying on the surface. So earth mass is given, earth radius is given, and universal gravitational constant 6.67 multiplied 10⁻¹⁻ newton meter square per kg square. Okay, using this formula, this is the universal gravitational force formula between the two objects m and small m. Okay, so this g is universal gravitational constant and this r is the distance between the two objects. In our case, r is the radius of the earth. Capital M will be the earth mass and small m will be the object mass, in our case 1 kg. So let's use this formula. Write the steps first. First thing we will do is declare variable, give value then we will use formula. Okay, these are the steps, and then we finally display our result. So these steps, okay, so first thing we have to do is give a program, and I will give a force, you can give any name, and don't forget to write in program. Then implicit none. Okay, now let's declare our variable. So first thing, okay, let's use the concept of a constant variable. Since universal gravitational constant, it is the constant value. So let's use real, because that is in real. Use the keyword parameter to make a variable constant. So we write capital G and give the value on the same place while giving constant. So 6.67 multiply, but for the 10 power to write in scientific notation, we use E minus 11. Okay, and one thing, photon is case insensitive. It means whether you write capital G or small G, it doesn't matter, it will understand G. So it's up to you whether you write capital G or small G. It's same as whether you write COST in small letter or COST in capital letter, or you mix. So it doesn't matter whether you write in uppercase or lowercase. Okay, but for our simplicity, I will write capital G. So the formula is capital M and small m, but we can't write capital M and small m as a two different variable, because it will represent them as a same variable. So what we can do is we can write m1 and m2, and I will declare another variable for the radius. Okay, I'll write capital R. Then our answer, force. Okay, now I will give the value of m1 is 1 kg. Remember not to write the unit, we have to consider unit ourselves. And earth's mass m2, so 6 10 power, so 10 power for the 10 power you can write small e or capital E. Remember, case insensitive, 6 multiply 10 power 24. Okay, and we need to give value of r as well. That is 6400 kilometer. So I'll change into meter, giving 3 more 0. Okay, now let's see, remove one more space. Okay, now F equals to, let's write the formula, G multiply M1 multiply M2 divided by R square. So R, and for the square means to the power, for the 2 power we have to write asterisk sign and square. Now it's better to give small bracket to avoid any error. Remember, always parenthesis comes at first while performing calculation. So it will first calculate this parenthesis and this parenthesis, and it will divide 2 answers. Okay, so that's also completed. Now let's display, use a print statement. So I will write yeah. So F is the answer, but it's better to write some text also. So I'll write force between them is. Okay, and remember to use comma separator. Now our program is completed. Let's run our program. Okay, we got force between them is 9.77, approximate to the value of small g acceleration due to gravity, since our mass is 1 kg. Now you can change the value and reprint the answer. Okay, let's use 70 kg mass. Let's see. Okay, approximately 683 newton. We have used real and integer data types so many times. Now let's see other remaining data type, complex, logical and character in use. First let's use complex data type. So I'll write program, and I'll write we can't keep complex here. There are certain reserved word in Fortran which you can't use for the program name or variable name. So complex is a data type and it's a reserved word for Fortran, so you can't give complex here. Okay, I will write example, doesn't matter. Okay, and program. Okay, and implicit none. Okay, first I will give complex data type. So like a real integer, you have to write complex and give a variable name. I will give variable, you can give any. Okay, I will give a and b. So I am declaring two variables, a and b, to store a complex value. Now let's give the value of a. Remember, for the complex consists of two parts, real part and imaginary part. So you have to give real part at first and comma and imaginary part at last. I'll give example of 3 and 4. Okay, and b equals to, let's give 1 and minus 2. Okay, now let's perform some mathematical operation on a and b. Print. First, I want addition of a and b, then I want difference of a and b, I want multiplication also, complex multiplication, and I want division too. Okay, so let's print out the result. Okay, gfotal. Okay, and so we got our answer. So the first one is the sum. Okay, as you can see, 3 and 1 first, real plus real, 3 plus 1, 4, and imaginary plus imaginary, 4 minus 2, 2. This is the difference, a minus b. So that is the difference, 2 and 6. So answer also comes in a complex form, consisting of first part real and second part imaginary. Now the important thing is, it can perform the multiplication and division too. So if you calculate by hand, you will get the same result. So this is about the complex. Now let's go for character. Okay, now I'll give character, charact, character in data type, and give a variable name. You can give any name. I will give text. Text is equals to, okay, now you can write any text you want. I'll write welcome. Now let's print the text. Okay, now if you see the result, you might be amazed. The result is just W. The text is welcome, but it has printed out the single character, because the character data type, character means the single letter. It can be a number or alphabet, but character is the single bit. But we have given text to print, so it can't print out the entire text. Like in a real or integer, to display more values, we give a kind specifier. So similarly, in the character, we have to use one specifier called len, that means the length. So how many characters you want to print? Okay, I will say just 4. I want 4 characters to be printed out. Now let's print it. WELC, that is the 4 characters only. Now what if you don't know the length of the text? So it's better to give length big value. So I'll randomly give 20, but don't give more, because if you give more, then the system will allocate that much memory. So it's better to give a significant value. So I'll write 20. Okay, and I'll print out. So it prints welcome. So welcome is just about 7 characters, but I have told to allocate 20 space for the characters. So this way you have to use the character data type. Just remember, to use character, always use the len specifier also in a bracket. Now the last data type is the logical one. So I'll give logical and give variable. You can give any variable. I will give a. Okay, and I'll give b also. Now you give the value. Remember, logical has just two values, either true or false. So that should be given like this, b equals to false, false. Okay, now let's print out a and b. Okay, so we got true and false. So a is true and b is false, so f is the result. So this much for this video. If you have any question, write down in the comment below, and we will continue in the next video.